Papa's wife chose a non-chronic temperature. the key talk about the effect of money project. So there was a DMR study in 2011 by Simon Kirstenwood. And this is a best diagram of the so-called high entropy type model. This is a high entropy, this is the pure type, and this is what we did. And so we are focusing on this pure type. Then they show that there is a single phase transition from low field molecular temperature to the high field polar. So this is very simple. There is only one transition. But this is a phenomenon. And recently, there are several studies for the anti-phenomenon in the field. There are three papers or papers on this one. And these are done by the Zubrace, by exact randomization and the DMR key. And all these works consistently points the existence of the intermediate phase between low field quantum and the phase and high field polar. These 10 regions. And also these works pointed out that the possibility of new gap phase quantum and the phase in this intermediate phase. That is very interesting. And actually, that means that the physics of Peter's quantum scaling is much richer than in the anti-phenomenon. So this is very interesting. So our motivation here is to find out whether there is something more interesting in the modeling field. So basically, zero field or in the Bernoulli region, there is essentially no difference between the phenomenon and the cases, but the previous remarks suggested that in the field there is a difference. So we want to know whether the existence and also the nature of the intermediate phase in the anti-phenomenon case. And also, actually, as I mentioned, so far we have several challenging materials for the liquids, but all of them are mainly phenomenon. So we need some experimental example of the anti-phenomenon up in the air. So that is also our question. So our strategy here is twofold. The first one is a ground state study of the magnetic phase diagram by using parametric theory and induct annotation and also the linear algorithm. Here we mainly focus on 001 field, 001 in the field is along the spin quantization axis of Z. And actually, most of the previous studies are focusing on the 111 field. But here we are focusing on 001 field because of some reason I showed that in the presentation. And the second strategy is to realize the anti-phenomenon coupling. We use the initial calculation for material design. Let me start from this question. So, to study the ground state in our anti-phenomenon effect model in the 001 field, we use three complementary methods. One is dark annotation for rays of dark sampling for size, and the linear wave approximation for polarized state, type B state, and also we use a minor linear series approximation by using the drawdown. So in this Majorana representation, actually this representation is different from the original P-type. We use the former here, we use the two Majorana representations. So that means that there is no redundancy. And the original P-type representation introduced the redundancy and extensive space to meet the projection. But here, we have no redundancy. That means that we don't need to put any global constraints in the theory. That kind of advantage because usually the local constraints are very hard to treat in the approximation profile. So this is a minor Hamiltonian from this. We're using the two types of A and B. And we have in the field, we have interaction in the field, so we treat this task by using the transform time in the lab. So this is the result for the magnetization in the 001 field for the ferromagnetic case and anti-ferromagnetic case. And in the ferromagnetic case, we found a single tradition of low vehicle transmit in this case to tie to the polar system. This triple system is one of one here in the previous one. And this is a result for the unpacked case. And the existing main field, primary main field is shown by this graph. We have two anomalies. One is here, AC1, and the other one is here, AC2. And so if you leave this mean field approximation result, then we have an intermediate phase between the low field phase and high field phase. And actually, there is a small discrepancy between this minor mean field approximation and exact temporary field result. That transition result is shown by this blue dot here. And actually, we think that mostly, probably, this is due to primary side. Of course, there is a kind of large one in the potential, but this difference might be due to the financial effect because of the reason that we mentioned earlier. So, anyway, we are focusing on this undiagonal case. So, this is again the magnetization in the undiagonal case, and this is blue line shows the susceptibility, and this blue dotted line shows the minor excitation. Then, you can see that in this phase transition at VC1, susceptibility divergence. So this is a continuous phase transition. On the other hand, this the phase transition AC2, there is a jump in the magnetization and also the up. So this is a discontinuous phase transition. And actually, if you look at the Majorana gap, this is basically zero in the phase. So the local phase and the intermediate phase, they are both gaps in terms of Majorana excitation. So we found that this the very phase is also different types of the address performance from this distinguished from this low in the address performance. So we looked at every Majorana spectrum in each phase. So originally we have the electron K point, K black point. And if we introduce magnetic field, then the Majorana point shifts like this to go to the gamma point. Here is the balance. And the other parallel cone at the K prime point looks along this direction, second direction. They are going parallel in the opposite direction. And the further increasing magnetic field, we reach here, so this is the phase of transition in C1. There, the two parallel cones are connected by the line of the track. So this is the continuous phase transition from this Japanese. And again, using the magnetic field, again this line shrinks to the magnetic pole, and that line shifts further to the gamma one. So that is the second gamma space. And finally, this line of the gamma suddenly jumps out, and that is the discontinuous transition to the solar space. So this is the spectrum of the successive phase transition. And this is the result of 0-0 field, and if we tilt the magnetic field from 0-0 field striking by adding the symmetry allowed term that is increasing in terms suggested in correlation theory, then we found that the gap space are all gaps except for the transition point in the two phases. And if you compute the jump number in both gap phases, and we found that in this low field region, the jump number is plus 1. But in this double phase, the chance number becomes minus one. So there is a jump of the chance number 2. So these phases are both topological and distinguished by the chance numbers. So, so this is the topological phase transition in the Majorana terminals by changing the magnetic field. So we didn't change the direction of the magnetic field, so just change the value. But that is the proportional phase. So let me summarize the result of the 0-0 axis. So we found two quantum spin negative state in the low field and in the negative phase, and both are gap-resonant with the Majorana form. But then they are distinguished by the continuous phase transition by the formation of the line. And finally, it is mounting the polar space. And if you tilt the magnetic phase strategy, then these two phases are gap. And this phase has a positive plasma charge number, but this intermediate phase has a minus charge number. And the other part, the previous paper study on multiple potential, the results suggested that this kind of system is invasive. So in the low field phase, we have gap models and maybe this channel plasma. But this paper suggested the existence of gap and trace and finally for maybe this phase boundary is connected like this. But we don't know how this phase and this phase are connected in this context. That is an interesting question. And we need to learn the study for this one. Okay, so this is the first part. So we found a very interesting postgraph phase condition. At least around the 0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0. more simply pre-existing, and very much richer places in the development area. But we, so far, the, all the candidate materials have simply ferromagnetic carbon. So we need some example of the effect of materials. But the, anyway, this ferromagnetic carbon due to this so-called jumping electrons, and they pointed out that actually all these candidate materials are in the D5 configuration, and they show that the magnetic interaction is effective in one half of the several different coupling processes. And the most interesting coupling process is this indirect coupling in this orbital, and that gives us the ferromagnetic coupling in the orbital half. But they pointed out that also we can have another ferromagnetic interaction for the problem. But this is usually very small because large crystal is created, which is G10. That is why we have a nominal ferromagnetic system. So we need different systems for the other ferromagnetic. So we try to find the inter electron compounds. So we consider the F1 electron system. And this is the level scheme of the F electron orbitals. There is a large spin-off coupling between this octet and sextet, and this low energy sextet is further split into gamma 7 and gamma 8. So, and if we have one beta electron, and that is this gamma 7 level, and that is given by gamma starlet. And this gamma starlet is very functional affected by the deformation of the orbital spin octet and gamma state. And this is very similar to the ground starlet isospin in the different north state. That is the motivated us to find chemical markets by using this ground state. And so we try to find that in the transuranium 213 chemical compound by using the range superposition. And we optimize the structure for these over the combination of alpha metals and A-type. And we find that all the compounds are stable. And the interesting thing is that the size of this case change of this study that this is not hydrogen. So if it is, then it is a very compound given, not hydrogen. Then why we have So to find out the reason, we carefully examined all the perturbation processes, and we found that there are two dominant contributions to the effect of the this one is the indirect cooperative in the so-called diet and the alpha hotel. This is the gamma 7 and this is the gamma 8. And the, actually this linear is very to the T3EG for the 5 minutes. But the, and the, actually it was pointed out that this type of protein can contribute to under cupping. But the, it was small in the D5X, it was large distributed screen. But in this case, we have a very small distributed screening. That is why we have a much larger contribution from this process to the under cupping. The other contribution comes from this so-called F theta, X theta morphine. And this looks like a T3-T3 morphine D5K. But in the T3-T3 morphine D5K contributes to ferroprotein in that part. But in this case, I mean, F-electron case, this contributes to anti-electron case. That is because of this orbital shape. So here we have, for example, the indirect morphine. But it is not allowed by symmetry D5K. So that is a big difference between E and F. So we have, a better contribution to this process also. So in short, both the big crystal case and the very orbital shape can contribute to that better part. Okay, so let me summarize. So I talked two things which are related to each other. The first one is the gravity-based and we found the latest topological effect drawing from the favorite to the intermediate field. And they are actually distinguished by Chan Gamma in the Q-tip field. And the, I think that the perspective in this topic is, of course, we need to start to drive by the intermediate field. And also, we need a combined between theory and experiment. And if related to this perspective, we tried to have initial material design for young matter. That happened, and we found that the object from plus a linear 2 or 3 compounds can be candidate for the anti-technology. Of course, we need a material sensitive to compound this. And also, we need to actually, this is a kind of one trial to extend that candidate material. And the opposite, we have many other choices. For example, we have published a paper for another chance to have that company in itself, as we said. There is also the integrated topic, but we are very tired of that to talk about this. But anyway, we need further extended materials for deeper understanding of the intent. Okay, thank you.
Do this for one or two? Thank you very much.